Well, here we are. I think I'm gonna recline on this one. Just a little bit of pain on the tips of the fingers. You can see the blacks of the tire. The black on the fingers where I probably rubbed on the tire of the bike. Well, let's bring it up a little bit more. There we go. So yes. Wonderful night. It was another one of those nights where I had to meet one of the, gang members at the dinner, at the Pope's dinner. I had the opportunity. Now remember, appreciation and everything. I had the opportunity to meet one of the gang members from one of the trilateral powerful sides. And it was a pretty good experience. Very good lesson, very good experience. And and this all has to do with the previous vids, just a few vids back, upon my private videos. One of the subjects that I covered in my private videos was the yellow vehicles. And one of the yellow vehicles that I saw happened to be passing by the vicinity where I was doing my detective training for Hollywood movies. And real life, of course, everything's real for me. And of course, there is a straw man side, which is the fictional side. So, that incident tonight was connected to that yellow vehicle. And yes, it was very forthtelling. Now, what happened was there was a raising of the voices at the dinner line during about... probably about 6:30. There was no line. Everyone was already eating, and the dining room was probably about one-third full, maybe a quarter full. And I heard some... I had my back to the servers in the... parallel with the servers, facing the cross tables. And there's about 20 yards of cross tables. And probably about maybe 7 tables. So, as I heard the skirmish behind me, I looked around. I think I looked around. And I noticed particular drawings or particular emblems on the back of the, we'll say it was a brown type sweater or sweatshirt, like I'm wearing a sweatshirt here, said this one's purple. And it was a particular fanciful, very well known of the emblems, and I know exactly what it is because this video is referenced toward my private side. And, so I know, who was the gang representative. I know who it was and who they represented. That's more the word I wanted to use. I know who they represent. So as soon as I heard the skirmish, I looked around, I saw the emblem and I recognized it. And I immediately held my head down and started thinking. That's prayer mode. And I held the pizza. We had a big pineapple, ham pineapple pizza. I had a big triangle. It was the biggest piece of pineapple ham pizza I've ever had. And it was good, and it was nice and moist, and it was thin, and it was flexible. So I had the big, it was probably about a foot than 3 inches long and probably about 10 inches across at the base of the triangle, you know, heading toward the point. And so I was just holding that in the air and had my right hand on the fork with a salad, a nice mustard sauce, and just kind of like dabbling with the salad and thinking and waiting for this man, probably see what he was going to do. And I looked around a little bit ahead of me at some of the tables, some of the people, and I won't describe them right now, and however, let's see if I can think of a word to give me a keynote so that we can keep this public and a private message for myself. I'll just say, seems he likes church, and there was a certain, I worked at a certain pizza place, and a dough roller, a certain female dough roller, and she was very friendly, and we got along real well, and that would be my clue for myself. All right, so let's move on. And sitting across from him was a representative of the same, I'll say, the same type of, shall we say, nationality. There we are, same nationality as one of the persons in the yellow vehicle, and I recognize the nationality, and so, you know, we made eye contact and whatnot, and I'm sure word got around to the nationality of possibly what maybe might be a misinterpretation of my actions on the street, which could have been a bit foolish. And yes, looking at myself, I had repented from it, and it was on the foolish side. However, it was a lesson and something I needed to grow through. And so anyway, I made eye contact with him, and he was of the same nationality of the man who I turned around and had the emblem on his brown sweatshirt, who was raising his voice in a skirmish. And it's so, after about 3 minutes of my head bowed, or a couple minutes or so, I finally raised my head and just kind of looked straight and whatnot. And then finally the power came up on me to turn my head and look around. And I was looking around for him. Looking around, I didn't see him. And then it turned out that I finally did see him. I think he raised his voice again, and this time one of the servers was out in the dining room, and it seems that he was having a skirmish with the server. And then some of the dining room guards stepped in and said, "We need to keep it down in here. We need to keep it down." And so I got to experience that, and let's see here. Then he went, the man with the brown sweater, the gang member, you know, or that particular nationality. He could have been a gang member. I'm not saying he was a gang member. I'm just using that as my own personal reference. And he went up and emptied his dish out and whatnot, and I think he came back and sat down at his table for a minute or so, and then he got up, and then the server and him, or he might have initiated some more words of raising his voice, and no physical contact, just the raising of the voice, and the server was on the defensive. Just wondering, what's going on type thing. And so then after that, it was kind of settled down a little bit. Then it seems the gentleman with the brown sweatshirt causing the skirmish, raising his voice, left out the exit, and then he showed back up at the exit, and then him and the server and were having a nice low-key conversation, and the servers kind of looked at me and whatnot, and I thought to myself, this looks like a Hollywood acting job right here. Possibility, holodeck, hologram, everything like that. And then I was looking over at him more, at them more. I looked over at them more, you know, just kind of eating, looking over there, and I kind of watch a little bit longer, and then I look at my food and eat, and look over again, kind of watch, and then finally, just before he decided to leave, the man in the brown sweatshirt, who was causing a skirmish with a special emblem on his back, he made eye contact with me for about 1 second, and then he left. And I made eye contact with him, and then he left. Oh, and I bowed my head to him to acknowledge him, because we made eye contact, and I went like this. And then he left. Okay, so I finished my dinner and whatnot and got my seconds, and I went up, you know, to the server and said, I'll have the PI. Because, you know, PI is for pineapple at the pizza place that I used to work at, punching the computer. And he said, it's PA. And I said, you're right. So, he gave me a couple chocolate cakes and said, here, have a couple chocolate cakes. So I finished my dinner and everything like that. And I walked out. And there was a football game, college football on television. I watched a play. And then I decided to walk to the bathroom, and I passed by, and to the right, there is a barbershop. And there, sitting in the barbershop chair, was the same man that was sitting across from the nationality of the pizza girl that I described earlier in this vid that I used to work with. And however, it was the man that was this same nationality sitting at the barbershop as the man who came in and caused the skirmish. I'm not going to say nationalities. I'm not going to point any fingers or cause any reason to, you know, point fingers and whatnot. And he was sitting in the barbershop, and I saw him in there, and I made eye contact with him for about a second, just usual regular pass by eye contact, and he made eye contact with me, and I went in and washed my apple off, and I wanted to comb my hair. However, I didn't have the comb on me, so I didn't comb my hair. So my hair was left out nice and long and stuff like that, and I walked out, and he was still in the barbershop, and I was minding my own business, and I chewing on my apple and biting it, and I walked out and sat in front, or stood out in the courtyard with the guys. I had like 5 minutes or 10 minutes before I had to be out the gate. And I went out the gate. Let's stop this and we'll get another vid part 2.